hidden things, power-ups. You think you know Jesse Ventura? Again. I've been blowing your mom. I've heard your mom come. And now I think it's time you blow up the Texas Book Depository. I'm Jesse Ventura, and this is bullshit.
I was going to do something on quotes as part of my series on science and the media, and I was particularly keen on showing a few tricks of the trade by which people can be misquoted. I wasn't quite sure how much you all knew about this already, but then two almost identical claims dropped into my message box, which made it clear that maybe these techniques aren't well understood, because the people who messaged me swore that Ben Santer, lead author of a chapter in an IPCC report in 1995, had admitted to deleting a crucial part of the report that said humans were not responsible for recent climate change. The admission came, they told me, in an interview on the Jesse Ventura conspiracy show. But it's funny because after they gave me the link, I watched exactly the same interview and saw no such admission. Here's the clip.
Lord Monckton points to deletions from the chapter, and there were deletions from the chapter. To be consistent with the other chapters, we dropped the summary at the end.
Now, how can we all watch the same thing and come away with a completely different understanding of what was said? Well, welcome to the wonderful world of television.
After 10 years of experiment, television, first shown to the public at the World's Fair, now takes its place as a new American art and industry.
I guess I saw things differently because I've conducted scores of interviews for television, so when I watch an interview now, I'm not just listening to what's said, I'm looking to see where the cuts are made and where the cameras are positioned. And it's these insights I want to share with you. Look again at that Santer interview with a more practiced eye.
Lord Monckton points to deletions from the chapter, and there were deletions from the chapter. To be consistent with the other chapters, we dropped the summary at the end.
Do you see it now? That's right, the explanation Santa gave about the deletions was, ironically, itself deleted. Instead, the program goes to a cutaway, and another part of Santa's interview is inserted in its place. If we listen to the first part of the clip before the edit, it sounds as though Santa's about to explain what the deletions were.
Lord Monckton points to deletions from the chapter, and there were deletions from the chapter.
But? And? What? We already know there were deletions, Santa said 15 years ago, that changes were made to the chapter. The controversy is about what those deletions were. But for some reason we don't get to hear the rest of Santa's sentence. It's, deleted. Now maybe Santa didn't go on to explain what the deletions were. But if that's the case, then why didn't the interviewer ask him? After all, that's the whole point of the interview. It's the one thing the show and its audience want to know. The result of this clever editing is that a lot of bloggers, completely oblivious to the cutaway, are quoting Santa as if this is what he actually said. And even adding things they thought he said. That's the power of television. Producers know what their target audience wants to hear, and the film can be edited accordingly.
Doors locked.
The show itself contained old theories from 2006, like the black boxes being found, but the main thing I want to point out to you is the controlled demolition hypothesis presented. Despite it being 2010 and the main claim is that there was nanothermite in the towers, Ventura starts investigating the claim of superthermite after an interview with Stephen Jones. Jones claims he found explosive residue from thermite in the dust, and Ventura, a member of the Navy UDD team who never was a SEAL, despite saying so in the opening credits here.
I've been governor. A Navy SEAL.
Should have pointed out that thermite is not an explosive, but he failed to do so. Instead, he contacted Van Romero from New Mexico Tech to conduct a superthermite experiment. So Van whipped up a batch of regular and superthermite, drug out an old steel beam, and slapped it on there. Here's the actual footage from those tests. Here was Van trying to explain what just happened.
As you can see, fire burns and the beam slowly heats up. Now let's paint the superthermite onto the metal beam, subject it to a fire, see what happens. As we expected, the beam of the thermite is burning much brighter.
Wow.
It's a much hotter fire than we had before. So the temperature is going to rise in this beam more than it would in the beam without the thermite. Does it burn long enough and hot enough so that we have structural failure?
What was that, Van?
Does it burn long enough and hot enough so that we have structural failure?
Let's see what Jesse has to say about that.
All right. Anybody still got any doubts?
About your sanity? Of course. Notice how he did not answer the question and instead asked one of his own. He cut the video off before Van could answer his own question, and this is the clip that he does not want you to see.
Okay, so that fire burned pretty hot, but did it burn long enough to cause any structural damage? Let's put it to the test. Nope, looks like it's still in good shape.
Well, there's your answer, but it still didn't stop Jesse from going on to a rant about the ramifications of paintable thermite like this.
Imagine if this stuff was painted on buildings in New York, Boston, Washington, D.C., all over the country. That stuff could be everywhere.
Maybe in La La Land. And I just pointed out that your show is a crock.
Anybody still got any doubts?
Just cut it off.